Yo yo, what's going on guys? It's John back here. Just gonna show you through some of the balance changes coming next Monday, the 7th of August. Sorry if I sound a little funny in this video, I'm just back from the dentist and I had my mouth numbed and I am talking very funny, but we'll move on. Okay, so the cards you can screen are the cards that are gonna be either getting nerfed or buffed, along with the knight, which isn't getting nerfed, but it will be getting an evolution next season. So that's something fun to look forward to. So, first up, we have the Royale Giant. The Royale Giant, and this is just for the evolution, is going to be getting a minus 8.3% HP decrease. This will obviously affect the Royale Giant greatly. Still going to be a very strong card, but it will help. Obviously, I'm sure a lot of you played against the Royale Giant evolution, and it is, feels just so oppressive. This should help bring that down a bit, make it a little bit easier to defend and play against, and just generally better for the overall kind of health of the game. Okay, next up, we have the Goblin Giant. Now, the Goblin Giant is actually getting a buff. Now, this may come as a surprise. Who, people don't really use the Goblin Giant outside that one Sparky deck. So, maybe this will make the Goblin Giant a bit more of a versatile and overall used card. Maybe it won't. We'll have to wait and see. But the Goblin Giant will be getting a 6% increase in the THP. So, that'll make it stay alive a bit longer on the field, give your Spear Goblins a little bit more time to do some damage. Probably just help a bit to get a bit more chip damage in, but overall I don't know if it'll make much of a difference to the game, because it doesn't seem, the Goblin Giant is never really a priority go-to for a giant card, except for in that one Sparky deck, so I'm not sure how useful this buff actually will be. Next up we have the Mighty Miner. The Mighty Miner will be getting a slight nerf, so the time that it takes to hit its full charge towards doing its full damage. So as you can see on the screen here, it'll be 1,000 for the level 11 card. That ramp up will now take an extra 12.5% longer to charge. So I'm not quite sure what the time was, but say it took 2 seconds to get to its full charge beforehand. Well, now it's going to take 12.5% longer, so you have like 2.5 seconds to get that full charge where it's doing that kind of 400 damage per second. Okay. Next up, we have the Tesla. Now, the Tesla will be getting a slight buff. The attack speed will be going from 1.2 seconds to 1.1 seconds. So it's going to be a slightly faster attack speed. And this will obviously be good news for any of you Expo players out there. The Tesla's always kind of been a good card to go with it. As well as the Knight getting its evolution, this could be a strong season for Expo. So that's something we do need to look out for. But the slightly increased attack speed should make this card overall a more competitive card with the rest of the standing, as it's currently right now being kind of outshined by Bomb Tower especially, or Cannon. Tesla's just never really a go-to, but this might make it a bit more of a versatile card, fit in other decks. Okay, next up we'll go to the Battle Ram. The Battle Ram is getting a buff. So, the distance that it takes to charge will be decreased by 14.3%. So, say they have to run 4 tiles to get to their full speed, as we can see on the screen. Well, that'll be 14.3% faster. So they'll get to their max speed faster, as well as the Battle Ram will have 6% additional HP. This is a good buff, this will keep the Ram alive longer, and them situations where you're getting close to the tower but just not quite connecting will hopefully be flushed away a bit, and this will make Pekka Bridge Spam a much more viable deck, as we know Pekka Bridge Spam hasn't been kind of a meta deck in a long time. This should hopefully make Pekka Bridge Spam and other Battle Ram decks kind of more in the meta, bring them forward, because Battle Ram is a fun card and I don't think it gets enough love, because it is a good easy card to counter, but it is also can be a strong card if left unchecked. And for 4 elixir it is a good quality card, so hopefully we see a bit more Battle Ram decks coming forward. Next we have the Skeletons. Now the Skeletons is just an evolution. The skeleton card cycles for the evolutions have been changed from 3 cycles to 2 cycles. I haven't used the skeleton evolutions, but I have played a team with them, and I notice sometimes they're not getting their evolved skeletons until kind of the last 30 seconds of the match. This will bring it forward a bit. It'll now be on par with the Firecracker, obviously in 2 cycles. So this will make this about a bit of a better card, but there also will be a slight nerf, the maximum number of skeletons. So as we know right now, when it comes to evolution, when the max number of skeletons that can spawn in is 8, as we see here at the bottom, this is now going to be changing to 6, so the max number of skeletons will be 6. So every 2 cycles we can get the skeleton evolution, but it'll only be 6 skeletons, up to 6 skeletons at a time. And lastly, we have the Firecracker. Now, Firecracker is going to be in a big nerf. So, this is just for the evolution, not the default Firecracker. So, the evolution's hit points can be decreased by 9%. Now, they still will not die to arrows, but it will kind of help just get rid of that card on the field a little bit easier and hopefully take away from the sheer power of the Firecracker. As we know, the Firecracker right now is insane. It's a very good card. Next up is going to be another nerf, which is going to be it removes the additional knockback when using evolution. So we can see she knocks back by the tile with normal, whereas after she's evolved, she was back by the tile and a half. This was causing people to miss a lot of spells, or she would just kind of always be out of reach. This will just get rid of that additional wee percent of knockback, and she'll be kind of more lined up with the default Firecracker. And lastly, there will be the spark buffs, whenever they're stacked, will no longer do like extra damage. So this means whenever she fires, we'll look at the screen here, but so she fires a shot, her spark buffs go out. Whenever she fires again, as of right now, if they overlap, the damage will stack. That will no longer happen. It'll do a set damage and it will not increase from that. So that's all the changes coming on Monday the 7th of August. Let me know what you think of the change in the comments. We will be getting the knight upgrade evolution, so I look forward to seeing what that kind of holds. Other than that, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.